Whether you're the leader of a group in crisis or of a group that is using the crisis to advance your position, the current times have much in common with your own past, which you surmounted. Think back to when you first started in business, whether it was truly starting from zero, from the formation of a new group or a venture, whatever sort, or whether it was simply your zero point. Those times were fraught with difficulties. You were likely scared. There were numerous uncertainties, and you were taking significant financial risk. But you're still here listening to me today, so the chances are that things worked out. It's essential that you don't lose track of the fact that you can harness that same resilience and draw power from those same fears to position yourself and your business for your future. The great majority of people out there, your so-called competitors and many so-called experts, are focusing only on things like CARES Act funds and driving more collections. They're among things that I've touched on the blog and in prior episodes of Business in the Time of Coronavirus. But if that's the only message that they're giving, and if that's the only message that you're hearing, then you are missing a very large part of the picture. Not only is opportunity inherent in a crisis, you yourself have already used the past equivalent of a crisis, starting from the equivalent of zero and growing exponentially over a relatively very short period of time in your own past. You can harness that once again. There are many tools available to you completely free on the WeissPC.com website, from books to blog posts to podcasts and videos, all of which you can use to help evaluate your current position, set your strategy, and begin to implement. On the other hand, if all you are looking for are short-term solutions to short-term problems, you are giving up your long-term future. Someone else will be happy to take it. So stay well, stay strong, stay strategic.